Everyone, myself Professor B.B. Tikke, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, and today we'll see the Advanced Engineering Geology topic of Residual and Transported Soil. That is the lecture number 23, and this is the actual section of soil horizons. In the soil zone first, that is the topsoil plus humus. Topsoil, that is the weather content of material of rock and debris, and humus containing material of humus, that is the degradable material. That's then zone 2. The zone 2, which is the surface soil zone, that is the oldest rock formation. The rock means a different types of minerals of bunch within the one combined rock, and it get eroded. Zone 3, like it is a different size and shape of gravels, that is a zone 3. And zone 3, completely weathered of rock, that is the virtually of all soil material. Then zone fourth, which is the highly weathered rock zone, the mostly soil material, that is a zone 4th. In zone 5th, moderately weathered rock material, that is a disintegrated and decomposed material. Then zone 5th, it is a disintegrated material and some parts of gravels. In zone 6th, there is slightly weathered rock formations like that. And zone 7, it is a unweathered rock with the fissure and fracturing in upper zone, that is the unweathered rocks, and it is uneven like features. Stages of formations and residual soil, that is a source, McMathy in 1922, the whole sketches, which is difference between residual and transported soils. As you might know, soil is formed by weathering of rocks. Soil is formed by weathering of rocks by either physical running water, wind, glaciers and gravity, etc., or chemical agency, oxidation, reduction and carbonation. The upper zone is oxidation, reduction and carbonation. If the product of weathering are still present at the place of origin, the soil is called residual soil. For example, bentonite, it is a totally finest material like that. It is the bentonitic material. Bentonite is a type of chemically weathered volcanic ash that is present on the parent rock from the which is formed. If the soil has been transported away from the place, like that, the soil has been transported away from the place. It is the transported soil, and away from the place means it is the depression zone. That is called as river valley region. And it is called transported soil. For example, alluvial soil. A numbers of regions we see the alluvial soils. That is the one example of Ganga River basin. If soil has been transported away from the place of origin of wind, water or any other agency and has been made redeposited, which is called as transported soil. For example, alluvial soil. What is the difference between transported and residual soil? There is a difference. A transported soil, that is the horizon A, which is humus and soil material. And residual soil, that is a horizon B, which is partially or completely weathered rocks weathered rocks agricultural only a residual soil used agriculture purpose residual soil have abundant in calcium carbonate CaCl3 much contained residual soil and transported soil consist of large part of material that has been wind blown or water or any other agency of transporting factor or medium. Okay, thank you.